So what I'm showing you is the correlation between the two stories, so you can understand the analytical depth in the Hebrew language that is showing you a correlation between the two characters that speak on their relationship outside of the secular historical preferences. And I said that so quick, right? Harriet stood up to help the slave who was in trouble. The overseer threw a rock at Harriet's head, causing her to suffer seizures the rest of her life. Harriet Tubman was truly a modern-day Moses, especially from the perspective of Torah deduction and inference. What Harriet Tubman accomplished in her day may not be as immense as what Moses accomplished, yet there certainly were striking similarities between his two stories. Also, the term Savta Moshe, Grandma Moses, is numerically equivalent in Hebrew to 808, which is numerically equivalent to Tachat, which means underground or underneath. Hence, when you say Harriet Tubman, what's the first thing you think about?
Underground Railroad.
I'm going to give you something that is not up there because I don't have time to show you, but it is in my book. Being that Harriet Tubman memorized all of the words and songs by heart, she knew for a fact that she couldn't use songs to help her people. Because the slave master also knew some of those songs because they were impressed by our culture. In fact, our culture birthed civilization here in America.
That's right.
If you didn't know this already, look up all of America's laws and you'll find out that they are based on the Torah's laws.
That's right.
America cannot conduct itself in a civil court unless it's using the Torah's tort laws.
Ooh, take your time, take your time.
That comes from the Torah.
Take your time.
Eye for an eye does not mean if you hit me in my eye, I can hit you back. If you read it like that, you don't understand Torah. You need to speak with a Torah scholar or a Torah teacher.
Or you.
Eye is about punitive damage.
That's right.
Just like it is in this country.
I need
so
my money.
My eye, you owe me for what my eye could possibly produce in terms of work.
I need my money.
Doesn't America do the same thing?
Yup.
That comes from the Torah. But we'll talk about that in another event. Harriet Tubman memorized all the book of songs, but because she knew the slave master also knew it, she needed to come up with her own songs to sing when the master was coming and looking for the slaves. So what did she do? She wrote a couple of songs. One of them was Swing Low, Sweet Chariot. Her most famous one was Waiting in the Water. Why is she waiting in the water? What is the meaning of the lyrics? What does it entail? Well, they had the dogs that were sicking the slaves that were running away.
Right.
But if you went inside the water,
they lost their son.
All over your body.
That's right, they lost their son.
If you went in the water, then your scent and the stench from you being out in the woods, the dogs lost it. They wouldn't catch you. So that's what the song Waiting in the Water was about. It's about her developing her own language through songs to avoid capture. You want to check something out? When or if you purchase this book, you'll find out in the chapter that deals with her that the term Mizmor Le'David, which in Hebrew means Songs of David, is numerically equivalent in Hebrew to Waiting in the Water. If you think I made it up, check the book out. Last thing I'm going to do is just show you something. I really want to.
Woo! What's his nationality?
But brother's got a goal, and my ego is not bigger than my brother's. This is an event that I have coming up with Yashuvel in Atlanta. It's called Good Cop, Bad Cop. Who y'all think the good cop is? It's me.
Word.
So Nasi Yashuvel talked to me one day. He said, man, you be going hard at the other side. What does he mean by other side? Anybody outside of Israel? And I said, yeah, because I don't like when you take pop shots at the Torah when a lot of y'all books is based on Torah. Shout out to my brother, Iman Rashid. You don't play. I said shout out to my brother.
Early.
Don't you dare take a pop shot at the Torah when your book is based in it. We'll speak on that in another event whenever y'all ready to.
Wow.
So, Good Cop, Bad Cop is about me and Nasi Yashuvel policing the conscious community. And we're going to establish a no-fly zone for y'all.
No-fly zone.
To tell us what Torah means when we gave you insight on how to speak about God in the first place. It's going to be a no-fly zone for a lot of y'all. And for you to come through and fly, you got to establish some credentials. And your credentials are going to have to be based on the Torah. which is the author of Fort Lexx, USA. This is a magazine that I'm releasing on the first issue as of July 1st. You can find me.
And that brother's so tall, he couldn't even make the magazine.
All of the information to subscribe to my magazine, you can find me. Or you can email me at 613LearnTorah@gmail.com.
613LearnTorah, you heard?
This is inside the magazine. Any events that you have coming, if anyone is a writer, please reach out to me by one of those avenues I just gave you. And the last thing I wanted to touch on, I won't because my brothers is bigger than my ego. Hallelujah.
I'm trying to get like you. Because I'd have stayed up there and
just keep it going with the brother John Lexx.
Keep it going in.
A Hebrew pastor. And you know, he's
the Hebrew mathematician.
He knows Hebrew. The brother, you know, enlightening a lot of stuff. Brother John Lexx, do you have your book here? Okay, so I apologize. The book is available right now on Amazon.com. You can type in my Hebrew name, Avdiel Ben Levi, which is A-V-D-I-E-L. Ben Levi, or Levi, L-E-V-I. It's on Amazon.com. You also can go into Barnes & Noble's.
Woo!
You can ask them to type it in, and they send it directly to the store because it's also available at Barnes & Noble.
Even the devil got it. That's right.
Support Hebrew Israelite business. So we're going to keep it going. Where's brother? Ashok, where you at?
Uh-oh!
There you go.
Oh, the Bronx up in here.
We started with fire, and let's end with fire.
Oh, the Bronx up in there.
Brother Ashok, come on, Brother Ashok.